Taking a look today at two Legacy Evolution Transformers figures. I really never spend a great deal of time transforming figures, but just for you guys, I have done that today. Basically, both of these figures are identical. There's really not a great deal difference between them in the certainly in the sculpt and the molding. There's really nothing between them. It is all pretty much paint. We'll get into that and show that in just a second. So the two figures, one is the Comic Universe Bludgeon and the Comic Universe Tarn. Both are older figures, or Tarn is certainly an older figure. Hasbro have been re-releasing some stock of Tarn back into some channels in some countries, so I finally managed to get hold of it. Picked up the Bludgeon just to kind of show you guys just a little bit more about the differences between both. So let's get a look at them. First of all, let's go look at the packaging for Tarn himself. So we get this tank-like vehicle, of which we've basically got transformed here. Just it's the different colours. So we'll show you one transformed, one not. We'll go through all that in a second. Packaging, pretty straightforward. So you get the tank on the front. We get a picture of the Bounty Hunter on the right. He does have a face underneath that mask. Unfortunately, we don't get it in the figure. But just to be complete, that's what it looks like in the comics. So he does have this purple mask which lifts up, and then you get this face underneath. So that's just to be clear. But it is the kind of Transformers logo. It's the original kind of Transformers logo, basically, on this Bounty Hunter's face. But he's a really, really cool figure. I have to say, this is more an action figure than a Transformer. It is super articulated, packed with features, but we'll get into that in just a second. Evil Fusion. Basically, you can stick things together. That's basically what that is. A few swap-out ways you can display the rifle as a sniper rifle, as a kind of a war machine-like piece on his shoulders. You can obviously do it even in a war machine-like way on his back. I'll show you that later on. There's lots of ways, and that's what Tarn will turn into. Tarn's UPC, should you need it, if it's of help to you, is there. And let's get a look at Bludgeon. And he's got the exact same tank on the box. So again, it's absolutely identical. The artwork, there's no real difference. The only difference is this kind of artwork on the side. Bludgeon has very much a kind of skeletal samurai face. And bigger Transformers fans than me will point out that he's not really quite looking like his comic rendition. It's very slight, again, to get that mold reused. We have had some very much more detailed and samurai-like bludgeons in the past, but this one is minimal. It's a Tarn repaint, so it's really very minimal. The big difference in this one to Tarn is the sword and the head. That's pretty much it, as well as the colours. Same Evil Fusion, same tank, 27 steps on both of them to transform. I actually thought it was 28. Some artwork on the side there from some of these older figures. And Bludgeon's UPC, should it be of help to you, is there. So let's quickly dive in and have a look at these two instruction booklets. Again, pretty much identical. Just getting a look at Tarn's there, just to show you the differences. As I mentioned, you can have his weapons on his forearm. You can have the giant sniper rifle. I don't think they show you on the back. Yeah, they do, actually. There you go. So you can see on the back, the weapon can be mounted basically like War Machine, if you know what I'm talking about. And through all of these steps, 27 steps it was correctly, you basically get Tarn the Tank. And that's what Tarn looks like here. Oops. It has to be said, this is probably one of the most annoying transformations. I really didn't like this and don't like the way it is. Yeah, maybe I've not done it too well, but it's not the best as far as I'm concerned. I've probably done these weapons around the wrong way. That's possibly what it is. Let me correct that right now. If I do that the right way round, probably as the instructions told me, I won't have that issue. There we go. That's probably going to be a whole lot easier. Yes, it will be. There you go. Ta-da! So when both of these are transformed, you get this tank-like mode. So let's look at that first before we get into the two figures. So it's a tanky thing. Vroom vroom. It does nothing for me whatsoever. Again, as I've said to many friends, I don't collect Hot Wheels, I don't collect cars, I collect robots and action figures, and this is of no interest to me. But when transformed, it looks like this, but with the sword. So that's the key difference we get, is the sword for this figure. which again, if we just have a quick look at there, you'll see very nicely done, very serrated edges, got the port that you can plug in. Again, we'll undo bludgeon in a minute and get into them, just to show you the vehicle mode, just at least on one version, so you understand what it's like, because again, both are the same. Whereas purple is orange, whereas green is black, so forth, so on. It's all right, but that's what it is. So again, the evil fusion aspect, and again, we'll show that in just a second. You can really do quite a lot with these. As it's got here, these can be tanked turret blasters. They can, as I've mentioned, go on to the back of Tarn and other figures like this, just as a kind of war machine cannon. And again, they can be individual blasters like I've got here with Tarn, which we'll get into. Let's pause, rebuild this bludgeon so you can see both, and then we'll compare and contrast a little bit better as we go through. And just like that, we'll have bludgeon. Okay, so back transformed into robot mode, which is way nicer in my perspective. You have these two action figures. Nothing else to really tell you about the bludgeon transformation at all. It's exactly the same. No difference really in any step. It's the same figure, so no difference. The only difference really is where you display the sword at the end on the tank, but you can put it in multiple places, so it doesn't really matter. So again, let's go look at Tarn and really appreciate what I think is... I mean, look at this thing. It is just... what a poseable beast. We'll get into the kind of articulation on him in just a second, but as a close-up for this guy, let's zoom in and get a look and appreciate just that epic-looking colour scheme, the purple Transformers logo, Decepticons logo, I should say. It is beautifully done. There's a gorgeous pinky kind of plastic aspect to some of these areas, which really lets the light shine through. There doesn't appear to be any light piping truly for... well, there is actually a tiny little bit for Tarn's eyes. Let me see whether I can get a little light going through even just from my phone, just to give you guys a bit of a rough idea. Did we get any? There you go. You get a little bit of light piping through there. So it's all right. You'd have to have a light really quite strongly above it. But just getting that light on that just shows you just how good that figure is, I think. The colour scheme, again, is really nice. We've got this grey treads everywhere. The silver, the darker blue, the purple. It is such an exquisite colour scheme and pretty accurate to the comic. So really nice touches, the gold, the silver that's going on there. The plastic feels like great quality for some reason. I don't know why, it just seems to be superior in terms of construction. It just feels very modern, very well built, and very well put together. Very well designed overall. So you can use these antenna here that are on the tank in actually quite a few different ways. And we've talked about the back where this piece here you can have rotated, you can have it turned round to have let me show you some other ways you can display these. As I mentioned, you can have the kind of war machine like display where you have the cannons on both sides of these pegs if you wish to do that. You can, as I've done on Bludgeon, just have them kind of sitting like rockets at the back. It's up to you. And again, you can have them as single blasters on the forearms. If you were to do so, you could, which is a nice look there, I have to say, that's quite nice. You could, if you wanted, store them, it would look a little daft, but you could technically have them on the legs, etc., and some of the ports. It's up to you what you do with it, and I think that flexibility gives you a lot more freedom in the figure and to pose it into whatever way you want. Again, Evil Fusion is a simple... connection here. You can do it in different ways. I think that's possibly a little bit more logical with the fatter end down there. And then of course he has got a large kind of sniper rifle like piece, which is really cool. Get it into a great pose. That's pretty badass. That is pretty cool for a Transformers figure. It is something else. There's something about Tarn. It is just a great looking figure. So again, Evil Fusion is pretty solid. Plenty of ways you can display and have these. You can also, if we take this back piece off here, and this is kind of came unclipped a little. Let me just pop that back in. I'll fiddle with it later. The point is that you can unplug these and have kind of kind of the best way to describe it. Kind of batons, if you want. If you wanted to, you could have them like so. So you could have them with kind of sticks or batons. It's up to you, whatever you wanted. You could also, I think these are port pluggable. So you could, yeah, you could essentially add these onto the forearm as extra weapons like that. There's all sorts of stuff, and I guess that this is one of the nice things about Tarn, is that it's really a kind of weird bionicle kind of, it's one of the best ways to describe it, as a kind of bionicle-like figure. You can basically build it in whatever way you want. You can really move things around with the arms, and just the fact that we've even got opening grip hands here as well is something else. We'll get into Bludgeon, I promise. I'm spending an awful lot of time here on Tarn. Articulation-wise, really pretty good. The head is on a kind of rocker back and forth, left to right, no real issues, but it's, you know, it is limited overall. Arms, you've got a full joint all the way up there, no real major issues whatsoever. You can twist and turn as well, so you've got lots of different posability on the figure. You've got this joint at the side there of the elbow, so you've got a little bit of movement depending upon how you want to position the figure. And then you've got this single joint at the elbows there as well. And again, you've got the wrists, which are ports, and obviously they open too, which is just fabulous. Really allows a lot of great movement. Articulation-wise at the waist, you've got a full articulation going on there. We've got the legs with look at that. That's just nuts. It is insane. So really lots and lots of movement. As you kick and move forward, there's this beautiful tuck as it just moves with the rest of the figure. That's an insane amount of articulation for Transformers. Just absolutely crazy. So I really do love its flexibility and its posability. You've got a double joint at the knees, effectively, if you look at it that way. So really, again, lots and lots of posable ways, and then down to these rockers on these ankles, which also tilt out, but really great posing. Again, you can get this guy into all sorts of high kicks and poses. Let me pull back a little bit. You could have him kind of, you know, kung fuing there, whatever you want to do. He's pretty flexible, and with a little bit of work, not too much work, you can really get all sorts of poses from this. Again, this is a Transformers figure, so it is pretty unique, pretty good, and really something you should definitely go and buy. This same figure is Bludgeon. There's not a great deal of difference on him. I should mention the flashlight piece I'll do just now for you as well. If we pop that on, you'll see the light piping, I think, should come up. It's not great. No, there's no light piping on this one. There you go. Oh, that's a bit of a shame. So I just assumed, being the same figure, it would have the same kind of functionality on the head, but it does not. So Tarn has light piping and Bludgeon has none. Well, there you go. That's a shame. Let's get a close-up of Bludgeon's face to really see the difference in the figure there, so you can really just kind of see that horrific, angry, silver-mouthed samurai face there. So that is his key difference. And obviously, what is purple is kind of slightly different colours here, obviously. The orange plastic instead of the pinky and other coloured plastic. Let me just bring them both up here. You can get a bit of a better comparison. You can see the kind of crotch area, purple and green. The main chest area, orange instead of the purple there for Tarn. And the forearms, green instead of purple. Treads, a little bit of different colour going on there. The Evo Fusion cannons are obviously orange coloured as opposed to those purple colours. They're really nicely done overall. And the big key feature, I think, for Tarn, obviously, is his sword. Otherwise, he will do everything that Tarn will do. And again, that just adds that nice touch to him to get that extra pose there with that sword. They're just great Transformers. They are great action figures, it has to be said. And I highly recommend you pick them up, at least one of them. Tarn certainly stands out better to me. The gigantic orange feet here, which is kind of comic accurate to Bludgeon. It is just not as smooth and as slick bounty hunter looking as that purple, gold, and silver scheme for Tarn. Look, that was just a quick overview, but I hope that helps you in your buying decisions for these two figures. They are absolutely rock solid. One of my favorite Transformers. And that is it. We'll see you for more figure reviews coming up. All the best.